Introduce yourselves.
My name is Manisha. I have done my graduation in Bachelor of Engineering and Electronics and Communication. And I completed my graduation in 2007. Since then, I'm working as a co-founder in my startup firm named Die Adventure.
What is that?
Die Adventure.
Okay. And what do you do?
I'm a co-founder and basically the managing trustee.
And what is area of work for your foundation?
It is for trekking and mountain running. We organize camps, nature education camps, trekking camps, and for a group of students, school, college, and also the young people who want to join.
And what is the purpose of organizing such camps?
The basic purpose is that what we have seen in Gujarat, and especially that I have felt, is that in Gujarat there is more inclination towards business orientation. So what we do is we try to approach the schools and the students and try to inculcate the spirit of adventure. We have various programs also. We also organize the in-campus activities in colleges and schools, various adventure activities which are there. And also we organize for outdoor programs in North India, Rajasthan, many other states too.
Now, this is a different ballgame altogether what you're doing. And your aspirations of coming to this place is very different. Why?
Since my childhood, I have been inclined to this public services as my father runs a trust, a charitable trust for poor students. And since then, I have just always felt that there is some inclination in me towards this service, being a public servant. When I was in college, I was in NSS, National Service. So at that time I felt that actually there were some limitations being a student, being a colleague. But I think that being as a public servant, going into the public services will help me utilize my capacities to my fullest, which I was not able to do then. And there is different satisfaction I think and I believe that I will get satisfaction which no other job apart from this public services would
Name five people who have really transformed India in post-independence.
One of whom I follow very much is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam sir, because we know about him. So then the other person whom I think is At India level, I don't know, but I know one person, that is Guruji Sri Jee Narayan, whom I have attended many times his lectures and MA. So he has inspired many educationists and many business persons too, many individuals, many youth. And I follow his principles. I do also read his books. So I think he is one of them. The other persons.
Do you, any of these people come from public administration?
Can I answer the last question? Actually I saw the movie Malavathukuna, and in that the role of that IPS officer actually greatly inspired me. That how he transformed a girl's life, and then she became the youngest ever to climb Mount Everest, that girl. So his role as a big public servant in people's life actually inspired me and made my determination more strong to aspire for this.
I feel, honestly, if you leave your passions for this job, you would be doing injustice to yourself, your abilities, and maybe you might be struggling into administration, because I don't find fit for administration. You are a different breed altogether.
Sir, I have that option also, which is open to me. Then after being in, as I said, that civil services or public services, whichever we say, is the best platform so that we connect to a larger people. I may be in a different field right now, but I think that that would limit me to a certain portion of public or certain portion of a group of young people. But if I am here, then no doubt I can continue with this, my passion which is there in my leisure time. And also being in the public services would help me to actually get a bigger platform for what I want to do.
You did your BTech, right?
Yes, sir. BE.
BE. What stream?
Electronics and Communications.
What are your preferences?
So my first preference is Deputy Collector. My second one is the Assistant Commissioner for State Tax. And the third one is the Deputy Director for the
Past. So you don't want to join police service?
No, sir. So because I've seen the profile, the work profile, so I think that I wouldn't be fit for device. That is why.
Two, three days before a result from GPSC came for a particular services which was meant for you, what is that post?
Sorry.
You did not try for that post?
Sorry.
Because there are limited entries for EC people in the government.
Okay.
So, what do you know about science and technology department of the state? What new ministry is formed in this new government? Newly included minister and given the charge of that new minister. You do not know. Do you know about Ganga Shuddhikaran Abhiyan?
Ganga Shuddhikaran, yes.
Which ministry must be doing this?
Sir, I think it will be the Ministry of Water Resources.
Now it is not a Ministry of Water Resources. It is a Ministry of Jal Shakti. And then this is the Minister. What would be your priorities looking to the conversation with sir? I expect from you three priority works you need to do after becoming a GIS officer.
Sir, I would like to be also in education because I have known and I have seen nearly my father working in that field. So I think that education is still India, we can say Gujarat even, that there is always a quality that is lacking in education, me also being in a government college or even a private college. I think I personally feel that there is always a better quality of education in private than government.
What is SSIP scheme?
SSIP scheme.
That is for to improve the quality in higher education.
SSIP section.
You don't know. What is startups?
So startups are basically any new venture that young youth undertake, and basically it is of any firm or company which is less than 5 years. I mean, just from the incubation, it is less than 5 years.
You know, Mr. Sarangi, newly included minister from Orissa.
Read newspaper or watch television?
Sir, I do, but I'm not aware about this.
Do you work somewhere right now?
No, sir. Apart from my this firm, I don't know.
What a common message you want to give to the women section? of your plant, if you are a plant officer?
Sir, firstly, I would the main thing that I would give is to see that there is no lack of education for any, like every girl goes to pursue that pursue schooling and education, because that is, I think, the main main part of which forms the development of a girl in her life, her personality. And the second one would be, I would say, to take care of the health. Because if health is good, then one can go for whatever one has to do. And being bold, being able to stand on one's decision, like what one aspires to do, should be one's firm determination.
How education of EC is will be benefited in governance?
Sir, EC, through EC, I think it would be like going for, as I said, that I am very much interested for education and health and all those purposes. Mm-hmm. Then I think that EC, the communication technology, could greatly influence or greatly change the way the lives, I mean the way...
Just think about a model, one module you have in your mind to improve the things by taking EC as your...
Okay, yes sir. The best thing is that whatever, like if there are no schools in any area, what one can do is like any philanthropist or any government official, whatever, so can go there, and through a simple projector and a simple screen, one can just impart education to any group or any class of students.
It is being done right now.
So that is being done, that is also being done, but if on a major level it is being done in schools, I think. And as far as this, there are...
What is smart classes?
So smart classes are the transformation of the traditional old classes with blackboards, chalk writing and all those, which are replaced by the technology, the new state-of-the-art technologies which are there, like digital conferencing or digital boards.
Do you know something about video conferencing? What is that?
Yes, video conferencing is a person in anywhere, any corner of the world, can talk talk live with the other persons and sitting in the next part of the country.
Do you think that this MSS system should be continued or it should be demolished?
Sir, as such, me being studied, I've been studied in the semester system. I think that it is a good system because it gives us a scope of a wider coverage of the syllabus. As every 6 months there is something new to learn, which does not bore the students at the end of the year to learn the whole syllabus again and again. But yes, proper evaluation, with proper evaluation, if there are any loopholes now, then they could be overcome.
In primary and secondary education, the government has taken a decision before some days to abolish the objective system of examination. You favor it or you deny it?
Sir, as far as objective system is concerned, up to some extent it is beneficial, as it covers some very factual and also some analytical portions that the students sometimes miss out on while studying the descriptive portions. But also just keeping the whole system or abolishing or keeping the whole system objective actually leads to many not loopholes but many challenges, like there are much more students just lack their students are now lacking their actually description power because they are just ticking and ticking.
Tell me one line about Gujarat written by any poet.
Sorry, Jay Garvi Gujarat, but I don't know sir, who wrote it. I think I could take a guess of Savage and Mithun, but I don't know.
Jandia was a Gujarati. Kandia Sada called Gujarat. Have you heard that line?
Yes.
Who wrote it? No idea.
I cannot recall. I have read that.
No.
I cannot recall.
Okay. What are the 9 pillars of Digital India campaign?
Yes. One is the digital infrastructure, the second one being the digital literacy, the third one being the, I think, digital connectivity, then fourth is this PMG Disha was also launched under the Digital India program. Next, PMG Disha. I'm just aware of these three pillars.
How your graduation will be helpful in administration?
I think that being a technical, being a like a graduate in technical field, I could help, as I say, that in education, the way communication technologies could be useful, or even in the other sectors like health, which is already right now being implemented through many other sources. So that could be enhanced in a better way if I am there and my team, with whomsoever I work, I can provide them with the necessary, not knowledge, but necessary, I think, resources or.
You are working in startup right now.
Yes, sir.
So what is the problems startup? In a general sense, we can call this that startup will be a white elephant for India.
Right.
What's your opinion about it?
Yes, sir. Actually, this is what I can say is that through the Startup India campaign, what is now being happened is that even though, like, if we are not willing to go for a startup, the students think, which is there, because I have seen many other startups too, which were started for a while and then they stopped and then they shifted to some jobs. So I think this is what the statement which you mentioned sees, because there is a lack of funding, first of all. Plus what happens is there are the ideas which are there that often overlaps in startups. So there is also, now what has happened is that in startup there is an increasing competition day by day. Even for a single idea, there are too many startups. So what happens is only one startup gets successful in the competition and the others are left out. So I think this is the biggest challenge which India would be facing, though it has it is having a large number of startups now.
What is the controversy of Angel Dex?
Angel Dex, yes. Basically, Angel Dex is if I try to define it, it is the tax which is levied on an investor when he invests some money as a venture capital in a startup. So now the government has already gone for that, and there is the controversy that they should abolish this or not.
So you told that your father is working in NGO, or he is the founder of NGO?
Yeah, he is the founder of a charitable trust.
Okay. So, you know this Foreign Contribution Regulation Act, in which year it comes?
Yes.
What is its benefits?
So the benefits are that those trusts or NGOs, which really need some funding, because there is always a shortage of funds if we have to widen our scope for the service. Anywhere, either in the government or in the NGOs or whatever. But what happens is in FCI, there is some, I don't know the limit up to which it is exempted, but if you get that much of funding from the foreign companies, it is valid in India. Like, you can get that amount, till that amount, in our NGOs or funds as donations, accepting as donations from the foreign companies.
Which NGOs blacklisted by the ministry in recent past?
Sir, I don't actually recall
that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is Mudra Loan?
Sir, Mudra Loan is being given to the small enterprises, I mean micro, small and medium enterprises. And it is started by, under the start, it facilitates the Startup India campaign and Standup India campaign.
What are the types of loans?
Sishu, Kishore and Taru.
What is venture capital?
Venture capital is generally that any company, any big company, which is there,
hmm.
that gives some funding as a, either in the form of equity or anything to a startup.
Name any one of India's most successful startup.
India's most successful.
Appreciated by government of India. Anyone? In any field. What is an academy?
An academy. Oh, sorry, sir.
An academy. What is that?
Okay, sir. It is a platform that provides the coaching for UPSC Civil Services Examination online platform through which professors and various other teaching personnel they provide lectures.
That is an answer of the previous question.
Okay, yes. Sir.
What is most favored nation?
Most favored nation is, sir. It is a term that is to be implemented by the WTO member countries through which that every country is treated equally and as such ideally every country is to give most favored nation to every other country, but it is not such the case in India as well as many other countries too.
Okay. Thanks.
Yes. Tax haven is basically a country, a region or place where we can say that there is less tax, that country is charging the less taxes. And so what happens is many of the firms across the world, they just transfer that base erosion profit sharing thing. They transfer their profits and all those to that country so that they do not have to pay heavy taxes in the host countries.
What are the arrangements for avoiding the tax?
So one is it is that pricing agreement, advanced pricing agreement.
Yes.
Sir, that is one which I can recall. Advanced pricing
agreement. Have you heard about double taxation award?
Yes, sir. The basic concept behind it is that in double taxation, when a company is situated in two locations, what happens, it does not have to pay the tax in one. In both the countries, it just needs to pay the tax in one of the either. And it will generally pay where the taxes are less.
Who is the Minister of Center in Women and Power? Minister.
Women in Child Development, sir. I think Mrs. Smriti Irani.
What do you know about Beti Batao?
Sir, it is a scheme that is basically for the empowerment of women, and through that, the basic education that the girls should get is promoted. Also, there is this Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, through which the girls are well for the finance of the girls, and so that they are not married under the age of 18 years and all those provisions.
What do you mean about republic?
Sir, a republic is where the head of a nation or a state is elected by the people of the country, the state or nation.
Last question. What is social audit and what two suggestions you would like to say about the social audit?
Social audit is a type, we can say a type of check on the government policies, or not on the government policies itself, but on the implementation of those policies. Like whatever work has been done on the ground is seen or is checked by the people of that area or region, and there that is, I think, called as a social audit. The people go and they check the things. Main thing is that generally the people are unaware of these developments. So as such, it has not been implemented on a larger scale, but there are some states which have done this.
Do you think Gram Sabha is a part of social audit?
Yes, sir.
It happens every four times in a year.
So Gram Sabha happens, but what is there, that people being still a large chunk of India being illiterate, they do not know that what exactly was given, what's mandated, and what exactly has been implemented on the ground. So that is why it is not being implemented successfully as such.
So many women are elected as sarpanch of the Gram Panchayat, but they are not ruling, their husbands are ruling. What do you say?
Sir, yes.
They are called sarpanch pati.
Yes.
What is yours, sir?
Sir, in that, as far as I think right now, the women should be more and more empowered for that, being even financially empowered, because that is one of the main reasons I would say for women being dependent on their husbands and they ruling the truth.
What the financial powers has the sarpanch got? How much of money they can spend?
You are coming from private sector. Now NGO sector becomes industries. What is your opinion about it?
Yes, as NGOs are different types, there are NPOs too. The NGOs, apart from the NPOs which are there, they after some years they turn into these industries. But I think that there should be, that is genuine, that's fine. But if someone is in future to turn my company into a private limited, right now I'm registering it in NGO and earning the profits. So I think a proper check, a proper regulation should be created for this. Or I don't know if there is any, but a proper regulation should be created for this so that we can stop, because NGOs are basically for serving the society. And the main purpose should not be defeated anyhow.
Okay. What is your name?
Imani Chopra. Imani Chopra.
Imani. Imani. Tame am to gami jao eva candidate to chho. But still needs some improvement. Amuk aspects tama ekdam clear chhe. Amuk ma tame dynamic situation ma to clear that aspect. Clarity law.
Sir, could you please tell me which? I know some, but can you please elaborate which aspects I am lacking still?
See, तमे अमुक जवाबो एकदम जेने कहवाय ने एकदम नटशेल में नथी आप्यो. Try to be precise.
Right, sir.
Preciseness लावो थोड़ी. થોડું નોલેજ વાઇઝ પણ થોડું ઇન્ફોર્મેશન વાઇઝ પણ હતી થોડું વર્કઆઉટ થશે. ક્યારે છે તમારું?
18.
ઓકે, એ થશે. બાકી તમારી બોડી લેંગ્વેજ, તમારું બિહેવિયર, તમારી એથિકલ વેલ્યુઝ, આ બધું બહુ પોઝિટિવ છે, ખૂબ પોઝિટિવ છે. જે એક ઓફિસરમાં હોવી જોઈએ ફર્સ્ટ એન્ડ ફોરમોસ્ટ એ છે તમારું. માત્ર હવે ઇન્ફોર્મેશનને ચેઇનમાં તમારે કેવી રીતે મૂકવી અને કેવી રીતે સર્કલ કરવી. સી, એડમિનિસ્ટ્રેશન ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ અ પ્રોપર કોઓર્ડિનેશન. કેવી રીતે થિંગ્સ કોઓર્ડિનેટ કરવી અને મૂકવી. તો સાહેબે તમને કહ્યું તો તમે કીધું કે યસ યસ ઓકે ઓકે, એમ બધું થેન્ક યુ સર એવું કીધું હોત તો વધારે સારું હોત.
બરોબર,
મારી દ્રષ્ટિએ તમને 55-60 વચ્ચે આજના પરફોર્મન્સ પ્રમાણે મળે, પણ તમે 65-70 કેન્ડિડેટ છો.
હા, थोड़ा इम्प्रूव करवाने की सारे
जगह थोड़ा सा आपको वो भी स्टार्टअप जो किया है आपने उसको अलग तरीके से प्रेजेंट करना है, बिकॉज दैट गिव्स अ वेरी कंफ्यूजिंग एंड कंफ्लिक्टिंग इमेज अबाउट यू. दूसरा
ओके, राइट,
थैंक यू सर.
नहीं, आवाज तो बराबर. दूसरा, जैसे I felt like you are more inclined on spirituality. जब हम inspirations की बात कर रहे हैं, तो you bring very strong personalities. ठीक है, पांच बोला उसमें किरण बेदी के नाम तो सबके जवान पे आना चाहिए यार. Being a woman, right? Service का अगर है तो मदर टेरेसा का आना चाहिए.
ये इतना मदर्स में तुमने इंद्रा दुई बनी ने लेक्चर आप लोगों को पूछो. हाँ, इंद्रा.
थोड़ा सा और थोड़ा सा पढ़िए और क्लैरिटी निकल जाइए. किसी भी जॉब में किसी भी करियर में डुअल माइंडेड होकर के काम नहीं चलता है।
तुम्हारी थॉट प्रोसेस घनी सारी है, એને ચેનલાઇઝ કરો, એને બરોબર ગોઠવો ક્રોનોલોજિકલ ઓર્ડરમાં, એટલે કરશો એટલે પૂરું।
और वो नहीं भी होता है तो प्रेजेंटेशन वैसा होना चाहिए। एक्टर वर्सेटाइल होता है, ठीक है, बट जिस रोल में होता है ना उस रोल को ही प्रेजेंट करता है उस मोमेंट में। तो ये मोमेंट वाली बात है, प्रेजेंट ओनली थिंग व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। हॉबी छे
हॉबी
हमारी ट्रैकिंग, माउंटेनियरिंग, पेंटिंग, रीडिंग।
पंजाब पेंटिंग से जाओ
सर, थंजावुर पेंटिंग्स ए बहुत ओल्ड है, लाइक अराउंड संगम एज समय कही सकते। एंड ऑल्सो थंजावुर पेंटिंग में ये खासियत है कि गोल्ड प्लेटेड है, प्लस एम ब्राइट कलर्स, बीड्स, बीड्स नहीं एक्जेक्टली बट स्टोन टाइप वर्क जो है ये आए गोल्ड प्लेटेड।
गोल्ड उपयोग
सर, देर इज अ टेक्निक, रेडियो टेक्निक और कार्बन डेटिंग टेक्निक, रेडियो टेक्निक कदाच यूज
થાય છે। તો આ તમે જે પ્રિસાઇઝ હોય પરફેક્ટ
હોય,
રાઈટ,
બસ આ જ કહેવાનો,
તમારે એક્સપેક્ટ નહીં થવાનું, તમારે એ વસ્તુ કાર્બન ડેટિંગ છે તમારા મગજમાં હોવું જોઈએ, અને નહીં તો કાર્બન ડેટિંગ ઉપર એક પ્રશ્ન ઉભો થશે,
રાઈટ।
વલ્લી પેઇન્ટિંગ, મંજુષા પેઇન્ટિંગ બધું ખ્યાલ જ છે ને તે પેઇન્ટિંગ માં?
હા સર, ઓકે।
સુધી પહેલા તો હેન્ડ મૂવમેન્ટ તમારી બહુ જ છે, ઓકે, તમે આરામથી થોડું ઓર નજ સ્ટ્રેટ લેગને બરાબર બેઠા છો, રિલેક્સ પણ થોડું સ્ટ્રેટ બેસી શકો, હાથ અહીંયા રાખવાના છે, અને જ્યારે તમારી હેન્ડ મૂવમેન્ટ વધારે હોય ને એ શું રિફ્લેક્ટ કરે છે કે તમે એટલું બધું વ્યવસ્થિત વર્ડ્સથી એક્સપ્લેન નથી કરી શકતા, તો તમને હેન્ડ્સનો યુઝ કરવો પડે છે, બહુ જ મિનિમમ યુઝ થવો જોઈએ, બહુ જ તમે કંઈક એક્સપ્લેન કરતા હોય તમારી હેન્ડ મૂવમેન્ટ તો તમારે કંટ્રોલમાં રાખવી જ પડશે, ઓકે, કારણ કે ઇન્ટરવ્યુમાં સૌથી વધારે એ હેન્ડ મૂવમેન્ટ ઉપર એ લોકો જોવે છે, હાથ અહીંયા જ રાખવાના હોય છે। કોઈ વખત તમે એકદમ ઇન્ટેન્સિટીથી વાત કરતા હો ત્યારે એવા કોઈ ઓપિનિયન બેઝમાં તમારી હેન્ડ મૂવમેન્ટ થોડી થાય તો એ જસ્ટિફાયબલ, પણ એના સિવાય નહીં। પ્લસ બ્લફ બી ના કરો, જેમ કે મેં એક્ઝેક્ટ પૂછ્યું હતું 9 પિલર્સ ઓફ ડિજિટલ ઇન્ડિયા, એમાં ઈ ક્રાંતિ, ડિજિટલ હાઈવે ફોર્મેશન, એ એક્ઝેક્ટ 9 જ આવે છે, ઓકે, એમ્પ્લોયમેન્ટ જનરેશન, ઓકે, 2020 સુધીમાં આપણે જે ઇમ્પોર્ટ ઓફ ડિજિટલ ઇન્ફ્રાસ્ટ્રક્ચર છે એ કમ્પ્લીટ કરવાના છે, એ તમે જોઈ લો, ઓકે। ઈ ગવર્નન્સ, તમને મેં કીધું કે તમારું હજી તમારી જોડે 1-to-1 બાકી છે, અને ટ્રેકિંગ, ટ્રાવેલિંગ, માઉન્ટેનિયરિંગના બધા બહુ જ ક્વેશ્ચન છે, મારી પોતાની બી ટ્રેકિંગ હતી, ઓકે, તો એ મંડે કે ટ્યુઝડે હું તમને આપી દઈશ ટ્રેક, તો એ તો બહુ જ ક્વેશ્ચન છે અમારો, ઓકે, શું ટ્રેકિંગ તમને હેલ્પફુલ થાય છે, મોનોટોનસ લાઈફ તૂટે છે, ઓકે, રિજ્યુવિનેટ યોર સેલ્ફ, આ તે બધું, એનજીઓ, તમારા બધી વસ્તુ એવી છે કે આખું ઇન્ટરવ્યુમાં ચાલશે, સ્ટાર્ટઅપ, એન્જલ ટેક્સ, કેટલું સ્ટાર્ટઅપ બધા ફેલ થઈ રહ્યા છે, અને સ્ટાર્ટઅપનું બી આખું કહેવાય છે માર્કેટ બની ગયું છે, ઓકે, એનજીઓ ઇન્ડિયામાં એટલા બધા એનજીઓ કયા સૌથી સારા છે, તમને ગુજરાત ઇન્ડિયાઝ બેસ્ટ એનજીઓ પૂછે તો કયું કહેશે તમે? એનજીઓ, એનજીઓ સેવા, સેવા તો તમારા અંદરથી અંદર સુધી ઉતરી ગયું છે, સેવાનો ઈલા ભરતી રહે, સેવા તો તમે સમજો, સેવા એનજીઓ ફિલ્ડમાં સ્ટાર્ટ કરાવ્યું છે, એનજીઓ 1988માં કાપાટ સ્કીમ અંતર્ગત મિનિસ્ટ્રી ઓફ રૂરલ ડેવલપમેન્ટ દ્વારા જે વખતે એનજીઓ એટલે તમે શું કહેવાય, તમે સમજો ગુડ ગવર્નન્સ, જ્યારે વર્લ્ડ બેન્કે ગુડ ગવર્નન્સ કીધું એમાં એમણે શું કીધું, પબ્લિક સેક્ટર પ્લસ પ્રાઇવેટ સેક્ટર પ્લસ સિવિલ સોસાયટી, તો તમારે તો પબ્લિક પ્રાઇવેટ, અને તમે પ્રાઇવેટ સેક્ટરમાં એક સ્ટાર્ટઅપ ફોર્મ કર્યું છે, તો તમારું અત્યારમાં મૃણાલા વિડીયોસ, ઈ ગવર્નન્સના મૃણાલા 4 વિડીયો હશે, ઓકે, ઈ ગવર્નન્સના 4 વિડીયો એકદમ જબરદસ્ત યાદ રાખી દો, અને આન્સરને બધું તમે એક જ ફોર્મ કરો, જેમ કે સ્ટાર્ટઅપ, હજી તમે પૂછ્યો તો તમને ના ફાવે એટલે મેં ના પૂછ્યું, કે સ્ટાર્ટઅપ ઉબેર કઈ રીતે, ઉબેરનો કન્સેપ્ટ, ઉબેર એક સ્ટાર્ટઅપ છે, કઈ રીતે એડમિનિસ્ટ્રેશનમાં તમે લાગુ કરશો, તમે સમજો કે શું જબરદસ્ત રિવ્યુ સિસ્ટમ, ઉબેર યુઝ કરીએ, રિવ્યુ સિસ્ટમ છે, તો કહો કે હું એઝ એડમિનિસ્ટ્રેટર મારે ત્યાં આપણે એવી રિવ્યુ સિસ્ટમ રાખીશ કે હું પેલા લોકોને શું રિવ્યુ કરું છું, એ લોકો મને શું રિવ્યુ કરે છે, આવું બધું ઈ ગવર્નન્સ, આવું થોડું આઉટ ઓફ માઇન્ડ થોડું વિચારો, બરાબર, એના કારણે તમને બહુ જ હેલ્પફુલ થશે, ઓકે, તમારું પછી 1-to-1 લેશે ને તમારું ઘણું ક્લિયર થઈ જાય,
પ્રોગ્રામ ને લોકો કે લીએ સસ્ટેનેબલ ડેવલપમેન્ટ ગોલ
છે, ઓકે, યસ,
પૂરે દેશ નો પ્રોગ્રામ,
યસ,
ઉસમે જિતને ભી 17 ગોલ્સ હૈ, सब कवर हो जाएगा. दे वुड अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम्स, व्हाट आर द प्रपोज सॉल्यूशंस, व्हाट आर प्रपोज टेक्नोलॉजिकल इंटरवेंशन.
यस सर.
लोगों को पता ही नहीं है SDGs. यू नो SDGs? सारे याद है
टॉपिक्स. आई नो.
आज सर पर अभी कैसा हो रहा है कि लोग यहाँ पे यानी कल भी दो डिवाइस पे आए थे तो लोग अभी ऐसा हो गया बहुत जल्दी से एग्जाम आ गई. मैंने तो ये प्रोग्राम है ना वो चार चार घंटे का पिछले मई से स्टार्ट किया था. उसमें जो लोग आए ना उनको ज़्यादा वो बेनिफिट हो रहा है और एकदम ही टाइम कम आया है. सब लोगों को मौका ही देना है SDG. इसलिए मैं सबको यही बोलता हूँ कि थोड़ा वीडियो सर्च कर
लें
क्योंकि कल सब पुलिस के लिए बुलाया था तो 25-30 लोग ही आए थे 60 में से.
અને ખાધા નો બહુ વચ્ચે નો લાભ વારંવાર.